So here we are in Sin City, Las Vegas, Nevada.
Getting some video footage of this.
Home of three sports teams, a university, and many more. Well, four, to be honest. The Vegas Nighthawks being the new one, the Las Vegas Aces, the Henderson Silver Knights, and of course, the Vegas Golden Knights. Well, actually, there's also the Las Vegas Raiders, but, well, they've been going on some things. Well, after we settled in that night, we went to the Cheesecake Factory to meet an old friend of Uncle Keith's. To the Cheesecake Factory for brunch.
You haven't found a church?
Nope. Thought about going to Randall Cunningham's church. She had some issue. You see?
There it is. Wow. Diligent Stadium. Fortress. fountains in Vegas are the most beautiful thing to behold as a tourist.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
It's even more enchanting at night. After all that, I decided to go with Uncle Keith, and we decided to go ahead and take a tour around the strip, see what all the hubbub's about. After that, I asked him to take me to his university and to the Darla Loan Center, see if we can go inside. That'll come later in the video.
Gigantic, the Wynn and the Encore all Wynn properties, very big.
Warrior Circus Surface.
Oh, that's cool.
That's opened up, and people didn't think it was going to make it because the goal was to make it family friendly. There's acrobat stuff and all kinds of crazy stuff they do there.
At long last, we made it to the crown jewel, UNLV, the University of Nevada in Las Vegas. There we go. Yeah, see that? Oh, look, another plane's flying in. Flying into Las Vegas. We're flying out of Las Vegas. Whatever it is. Then we made it to the Fortress 2.0, Dollar Loan Center, the DLC. This building was built last year and opened in April of 2022. We got all the footage of the outside. Unfortunately, we couldn't really go in the inside and get some footage there. There was a private gathering and, well, we weren't necessarily invited. So we decided to move along. Now we've made it to Mandalay Bay, and it's time for the show. We first got a bite to eat at Strip Steak. And got ourselves situated. For at long last, we would then see Michael Jackson 1 from the one and only Cirque du Soleil. Now about the show, it's very technical, and not to mention, it's probably very expensive. The set pieces, the design, and the 3D and special effects were something to behold. Especially the set piece in the outside. The venue is exceptional, especially the statues. Then it was time to go in and experience Cirque du Soleil's Michael Jackson 1. The best part about the Vegas Strip is how illuminated it can be at night, especially if you're a tourist. Not to mention, Mandalay Bay is huge. I was thinking it'd be like an arena or something, but no. It's full of venues. So much so that it's not an arena. It's more like a convention center, if you will.
Well,
and it has casinos as well, of course, because, well, it's Vegas. But not only that, it also has a pathway to Allegiant Stadium and also Michelob Arena, home of the Las Vegas Aces,
where were you going?
Who, if not mistaken, have to won their championship this year.
High Rover Transportation.
Pinball looks like it's doing good business over there, too. I can imagine somebody wanting to do a pinball machine. Classic arcades. And I mean, anything that you see here, if it's open, it's got a lot of.
So yeah, there you have it, day two of the Vegas trip. We went through the strip all the way to the university, and we went to go see Michael Jackson 1 by Cirque Olé. And what an amazing show it was. Now I won't give you any spoilers, but let's just say that they use a lot of dazzling effects that will make your heart stop, so I would recommend checking them out next time they're at your city. Now, without further ado, the moment you all been waiting for, to the Vegas Golden Knights game. Hope you guys enjoy.
You got about an hour to do so. We got about 1 hour until Patron. So happy to have y'all back, so happy to have y'all back. Welcome to the fortress.
Back here at the Fortress, and we are ready, season 6, to welcome everybody to the Golden Age. All right, so as we capture most, I know we're gonna have a lot of fun. You get on social media, use the hashtag the Golden Age. And as always, Vegas Bowl. All right, so we're gonna have a good time. Make sure you guys stick around. Stick around, the players will be on the ice shortly for warm-ups. Hang out with us.
I think we got some locker room footage. That's what I heard. Let's see if we got any fun stuff. Oh, look, there they are. They're getting ready. Jack Eichel getting ready.
There he is.
Warm-ups are taking place really, really soon. The guys are getting ready. We can't wait to see them out here on the ice in our home in the fortress. We will see you guys real, real soon. Have fun at warm-ups. See you guys in a second.
There you go, there you go. Come on. Get out of there! Get out of the zone! There you go, there you go. Come on! Whoa, come on! Yeah!
Fiala. 2 minutes for holding. Johnson Penalty 17:07 in the first period. Fiala, 2 for holding at 17:07. That means your Golden Knights are on the
Come on, get in there.
Thank you. Shay! Shay!
Come on, power play goal. Come on.
Kevin Fiala, 2 minutes for slashing. Tom DePetley, 11:43 in the second period. Fiala, 2 for slashing at 11:43. That means you're going to knight or on the NBRG.
Other way, other way. There you go. Come on. Come on, get in there. Get out of your zone. Come on.
That concludes the second period.
Oh, hey everybody! It's good to be back. How you feeling? Good to be back, people.
Woo!
Let's see if we can get this third period going properly. It's time for nightclub. It's time for nightclub with DJ Joe Green.
Nightclub featuring DJ Joe Green starts in 5, 4, 3, 2.
Los Angeles 2009, 2 years.
Pelly, call number 9, Adrian Kempe, 2 minutes for the appearance. Tefla Pelly, 5:09 in the third period. Kempe, 2 for the appearance at 5:09. That means your Golden Knights are on the NVRG!
Come on, get it in there! Come on, give me something. Get out there!
Vegas penalty called on number 7, Alex Pietrangelo, 2 minutes for hooking. Got the penalty at 110 of overtime. Pietrangelo, 2 for hooking at 110.
But hey, at least we won the shootout, so there's that.
Yeah!
And at the final, I caught the goal for it live on camera. So, I call that a win in my book. Then, it was time for us to head home. So that was it. The end of my Vegas trip. We came. We saw. And we conquered. So yeah, that's about it. All the footage I got from the night's game all the way to the show, which I couldn't really record because of the rules. And quite frankly, it was pretty nice. My uncle's doing really awesome. And I wish him well, and I wish him the best of luck moving forward. I do wish the Vegas Golden Knights the best luck moving forward, because they're going to need it. And we may have not won the game, but at least we won the shootout. At least I think we did. And, hey, I mean, if we did, though, that's a win. That's definitely a win. Especially from, you know, the season before where we couldn't run any shootouts. All in all, it was a very awesome trip, and I want to thank you guys so much for watching this video. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. And of course, I will see you all next time. Take care.